All right, here's the thing. You travel, and then, you know, you come back from the trip, and you always put a few pounds on. Mm. Not Peter Greenberg. He travels all the time. Yeah. And they completely, how handsome are you? I'll answer it. The answer is very. But okay, here's the, from the travel detective and the great Emmy Award-winning Peter Greenberg, here's the tip. No more of the bread on the plane.
That's right. No more biscotti cookies.
Okay.
Oh. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
Because otherwise you just put them in your pocket.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
But I only eat those out of, you know, when it's an emergency. They're really not
that good. I have
that
emergency
good.
Every time
but
I fly.
But when you're on the plane, you need something. Exactly.
Absolutely.
The acclaimed PBS series, The Royal Tour, you start, who was the first prime minister that took your
role? Actually, it was the King of Jordan. Mm. 18 years ago. We started the show 18 years ago. He and I did Petra on Harleys together.
Wow.
What this is,
wow.
is I go to individual kings, presidents, or prime ministers. I get them to give me unprecedented access for 6 full days of their schedule, which become our schedule. And then, for the next 6 days, they're my tour guide to the country. Through their eyes, they have no right of editorial review. They have no right of control. The first time they see it is when it goes on the air.
And do they know it best? Like, in some ways, you think, well, they must.
Well, you remember, they were born there. They grew up there. We're not just doing the iconic locations. We're going to their hometown, their village where they went to school. We're having some fun, too.
So this time it's Poland.
It is.
Which I have heard is a fantastic place to go.
When I grew up, I watched Poland on TV in black and white.
Right, exactly.
It was a very bleak, Soviet-dominated bloc country. I never saw anything in color. This is unbelievable. People forget, 1,000 years of history. Other than Wales, I think they got the most castles. It was a kingdom. Of course, they've also been invaded by everybody more than once, occupied by people more than once. So what an unbelievable history. Now, we can't really distill it all in 1 hour, but let me tell you something. The prime minister takes me everywhere, and we're doing it in every kind of vehicle you can imagine, and we're having fun.
You just have amazing access that other people don't get because you're with the prime minister.
Exactly. Well, here's what the deal is. The reason why I get that access is not because of my sparkling personality, I'm sorry to report.
Well, there is that.
It's because of the numbers. Travel is one of the largest industries in the world. It's 11% of global GDP. It's one out of every 10 jobs, which is even more important. It's one out of every 5 new jobs. These guys know the numbers. But the deal is, I won't let them promote the country. We're going to present it. And there's a big difference.
And speaking of presenting, and I know many people who've done this, there's another part of Polish history as well. Had you been to Auschwitz before?
I've been to other concentration camps before in Germany. This is the first time I went to Auschwitz. I have to tell you, I lost it. It is the most emotional thing, and in fact, I think everybody should be required to go see it. And kids in Poland, by the way, they are required to go see it. Just like kids in Japan are required to go to Hiroshima and Nagasaki, because if you don't remember it, you're going to repeat it.
We talked on the phone prior to your visit here today, and I had said, isn't there like a salt restaurant or a salt hotel?
Oh, my God. There is a city of salt, undermined. I mean, it's one of the biggest mines in the world. They built everything out of salt. Everything you see there, even the chandeliers, are salt.
And is there an aroma to it, or what?
No, there's no smell at all. At one point, salt in Poland was like coal in Wales and oil in Saudi Arabia. It's what bolstered their entire economy.
Jessica wants to know how the pretzels are.
No, she wants to know the kielbasa and the pierogies. Come on.
That too.
Great.
That is interesting, because I think we all have things we want to show off about our country. In a proud sense, does he say, you've got to try this? This is my favorite food.
And by the way, when the prime minister, the president, or the king says, you got to try it, you try it.
Uh-huh.
You don't back out. I mean, when the president of Mexico wanted to rappel 1,600 feet into a bottomless pit, I went.
Wow.
You know,
wow.
So that's what you do.
Doha is on your list soon. Is there any place you haven't been to?
Camden, New Jersey.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. No, look, there are 196 countries in the world. I've been to 151 of them, which is,
incredible.
By the way, 150 more than most Americans, because if you're watching the show and you don't have a passport, shame on you. There are only 37% of the American public has a passport. That's terrible.
You know, I remember very vividly a conversation we had. I had a chance to do a press trip to Egypt, and my eldest daughter at that time was about 12. Mm-hmm. And I said, is it irresponsible to take her to Egypt, you know, safety concerns? And you yelled at me, and you said, it's irresponsible not to take her,
exactly.
Which was the best advice.
I was in Egypt a month and a half ago. It's fine.
Mm-hmm. Where else would you tell people this summer? Where should we go?
Well, if you really want some hot spots, everybody looked at Iceland last year, right?
Yeah.
Go to the Faroe Islands. Mm. The Faroe Islands, most people don't know where they are. It's between Norway and Iceland. The smallest capital in the European Union. They've got their own Philharmonic Orchestra, but the best place to watch the Northern Lights. Mm. You want a safari? Don't just go to South Africa. Go to Namibia. Go to Rwanda, that was our last royal tour last year, by the way. And then I'm going to give you one that nobody's been to. St. Helena. Do you know where it is? Okay, it's right smack in the middle of nowhere in the South Atlantic. 1,200 miles from Angola, 1,800 miles from Brazil. It's where they exiled Napoleon. Now, most people think they exiled him in Elba. They did, but he escaped.
Ah.
and he fought the British at the Battle of Waterloo, and he lost. And he so pissed them off that they said, okay, we're going to send you to the one place you can never leave. And it was St. Helena. He got there in 1815. He died in 1821. It's still a British overseas territory. They still have a governor general there, and it's gorgeous.
Oh. Wow. How do you get there?
They got, here's a news bulletin. Last year, for the first time ever, they got an airport.
Oh, wow.
But wait, one flight a week, weather permitting.
Wow. No. Oh, okay.
So if you, wait, you the business is if you miss the flight, you're there for another week.
Yeah.
Come on.
Premiere is tonight, but you can watch Poland, the Royal Tour on PBS. It'll start April the 22nd. Peter, always good to see you.
And KCET on May 1st.
May 1st.
Thank you, Peter.
You got it, guys.